Hey guys, welcome back to our channel, and if you are new, hello, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe down below. This is just a channel where me and my husband make fun videos just of our lives and things like that. But hello. So anyway, I just want to jump right into the video because our last vlog, we kind of left you guys on a cliffhanger, and you guys are probably thinking, what the heck? Like, what's happening to them? What's the secret? Like, what is it? Tell us. So we wanted to get this video up for you guys so you guys can be filled in. So anyway, in this video, I'm going to be talking about our kind of fertility story, us trying to conceive, to give you guys a little bit of background. Me and my husband have been trying to conceive for about a year and a half at this point. And you would think that it's something really easy and natural, you know, first you get married and then you have kids and you start your family. And unfortunately for us, it hasn't been that simple. It's actually been a difficult, long road, and we're still kind of on the journey. And I always imagined that I would be like posting about this and telling about it when I actually got to the point of having a baby, but I thought, you know what, I'm just gonna let everybody kind of in on our lives and tell you guys what's been going on with us. So I'm gonna go ahead and tell you guys our story. So this all started back in July of 2017, and me and Josue kind of decided maybe we should start like kind of trying for a family. And when we decided this, we weren't like actively like trying, but we weren't protecting against it, I guess you could say. And lo and behold, the next month in August of 2017, we found out we were pregnant. And we were like, whoa, that was fast. We did not expect it to happen so fast, but it did, and we were excited. Josue was really shocked, but we were really happy about it. Anyway, we ended up going to our first doctor's appointment, which is supposed to be exciting and fun, but I was so nervous for it. And when we got there, we were supposed to be, they had estimated that we were going to be 8 weeks pregnant. And then when they did the ultrasound, we actually found out that we were 6 weeks pregnant. So that was a little bit, not odd, but I don't know, it was a little bit out of the ordinary because it was off from what they had predicted. Anyway, we had gone to the ultrasound, they checked, we were able to see the heartbeat, which was crazy and just really amazing to see that. And you know, they printed us off a picture, we left thinking everything's good and fine, we saw the heartbeat, all is well. And then 5 days later, I got a call from the doctor, and it was kind of late at night, and so I was thinking like, why is she calling me? Like, what is this about? And my stomach dropped because I thought, oh, this can't be good. So I ended up picking up the phone, and the first thing that she tells me is, we have some concerns about your ultrasound. And honestly, after those words, I kind of had like a mental block, and everything she was saying seemed like a blur. I couldn't focus in on anything she was saying. I ended up getting off the phone and I just started bawling. Like, I was so emotional, I was so like fearful. And Josue ends up running upstairs and he's like, what's wrong? Like, what happened? And I was like, I got off the phone with the doctor and she said there's something wrong with the baby. And he's like, okay, like, what's wrong? I was like, I don't even know, I can't even hear what she said. And he's like, you have to call her back. So I ended up calling her back to try to get the details on what was wrong. And there was a list of things that were not right with the baby that they saw in the ultrasound. First, I guess the heart rate was low. Then also, they call it the fetal pull, which I guess is essentially the baby itself, they said was irregular, as well as I had what's called a subchorionic bleed or something like that. And anyway, a list of problems. We ended up having to go back and get ultrasounded a second time to see what's going on. So I was so scared for this ultrasound, and honestly, I was assuming the worst. And of course, when we go there, the worst did happen. Unfortunately, we no longer saw a heartbeat. There was absolutely no growth, and it had been a week and a half at that point, so you would have expected the baby to have a lot of growth in that time, and there wasn't any. And so the doctor came in and told me that we had lost the baby and kind of steps on how to go about that. We ended up choosing to go with a DNC, which I could go into more depth on another video, but that's just kind of what we chose. And so we ended up losing the baby and it was devastating. I took it really hard. It was not good. I was so sad about it. And anyway, then after the whole recovery from that and everything, we decided we would start actively trying again to have a baby. And kind of in the back of my mind, I thought this would happen really fast. Since it happened so fast the first time, I was like, oh, we're so fertile. This is just gonna happen. And when it didn't, that kind of like got me discouraged, I guess you could say. Months and months passed of just getting negative pregnancy test after negative pregnancy test, and then it feels like everyone around you is either having a baby, pregnant, has a family, and I'm just sitting here like, why isn't it happening for me? But we waited a long time, and I think after maybe 6 months of trying to get pregnant, we found out that we were pregnant. I had taken a pregnancy test and there was a faint line. I was really excited, and then it was so weird. Like 2 days later, I just started my period. And I was kind of like, what the heck? So I did like research on it and kind of saw that it could be a chemical pregnancy, which is essentially a very, very early miscarriage. Most girls don't even know it happens, because you would only know if you took an early pregnancy test and got like a faint line. And so that was a huge discouragement, because after all this time of trying, and then I'm like, oh my gosh, we're pregnant. And then it was like, oh wait, no, we're not. And so that, after that, honestly, I felt like completely like done with the whole thing. Actually, at that point, it might have even been 6 or 7 months. I think it actually might have been 7 months of trying. And it was kind of like, okay, after that, I was like, whatever, I'm not testing again until I'm like a week late, because the fact that that happened was devastating. And then it ended up being 2 months after that. So at this point, I'm pretty sure it had been about 8 or 9 months of trying, and it had been a year since the miscarriage. So I ended up being late, but I was like, okay, I'm not gonna take a pregnancy test, because if you're trying to conceive, you'll know after months and months of getting negatives, it's too much to handle, and I could not take seeing another negative test. So I ended up waiting till I was, I think, 5 days late, and I was like, at this point, I was like, okay, I'm taking a test. So I woke up early in the morning, took a pregnancy test, and sure enough, there was 2 lines on it. So then I even went and I had a digital test and took the digital, and it said pregnant on it. And I was so, so, so excited. Seriously, every time I even looked at the pregnancy test, I started crying with just like joy and excitement, and I was very, very happy. We ended up going to the doctors a couple weeks later. So at this point, I should have been estimated 7 weeks pregnant. We went into the doctor's appointment, they did the ultrasound, and sure enough, it was measuring at 5 weeks when I should have been 7. And this was the first red flag in my head, because it totally brought me back to a year ago when I was, you know, not measuring as, the baby wasn't measuring as big as it should be. And that was like hard, and I thought the worst, of course. I was like, you know, I'm gonna have a miscarriage again. Like, I was really, really sad. Anyway, they ended up saying I needed to get blood work done, and then also a week later do another ultrasound. So I got my blood work done, and we got 2 things checked: the HCG as well as the progesterone. My HCG was low, but it wasn't too low. It was low, but not horrible. And then my progesterone was extremely low, super low. So of course, trying everything in my power to make this pregnancy successful, I started taking progesterone, as well as I was on complete bed rest, just laying down, taking it easy, drinking lots of water, trying to eat healthy, all that jazz, taking prenatals, everything. And then they said I needed to do follow-up blood work 2 days later, and at this point you want your HCG to be rising. You want it to double. You don't want it to stay stagnant. But based on my progesterone being so low, my doctor had already kind of prepared me for miscarriage, saying, you know, it probably is going to happen just because it was very, very low. I ended up getting my blood work retaken and my HCG actually increased, which gave me like hope. And I was hopeful that, okay, maybe this is gonna be okay. Well then, of course, after that, I start cramping very, very bad. It was really bad. And I had figured that this was the miscarriage happening. I hadn't miscarried at home naturally before because the last time I had the DNC. So I didn't really know what a natural miscarriage felt like, but I've heard that is very painful. And I was like going through a lot of pain. I was at the point where I almost told Josue to take me to the emergency room. It was so bad. So I kind of expected that I had the miscarriage with everything that I was feeling. I end up going to the doctors to get that ultrasound. So it had been a week since my first one. And I expected them to do the ultrasound and see nothing there because I figured I had miscarried. Well, they do the ultrasound, and first of all, well, this ultrasound got kind of complicated. The first thing was the sac that, you know, of the baby was still there, so I hadn't miscarried, which I was like, what? Like, how was I going through so much pain and I haven't miscarried? That was crazy to me. And then second, they saw something on one of my ovaries, and this gave them concern for what's called an ectopic pregnancy, which is super horrible. And I was really, this is like the one thing that I was really scared about ever happening to me, but they say it's not that common. But of course they think it's happening to me. It's basically where the baby is growing in your fallopian tube or ovary, and that's very, very bad because as the baby grows, it'll rupture your fallopian tube and you have the possibility of having that removed. And it's, I was a stress case on this. Like, seriously, it kept me up at night. I was so worried that I had this ectopic pregnancy because my doctor brought it up and she was like, we're gonna have to do another repeat ultrasound to see if that's what's happening. I ended up going 2 days later to the doctors again, hoping, obviously, we weren't hoping for a miscarriage, but at this point the miscarriage had already been basically confirmed based on my blood levels, and there was no growth of the baby. So I just wanted everything to just like pass naturally and not have to do surgery again. And so anyway, we ended up going in, and thankfully everything had passed, the baby had passed, I had miscarried, and it all was well on that front, as well as whatever they saw in my ovary before had now shrunken in size, which is a sign that it's not ectopic, because if it was, that would have been growing. So all was well, and that was like a huge sigh of relief. Obviously I was devastated at the loss of the pregnancy, like that was really, really hard. But I was excited that there was no, not excited, but relieved that there was no other issues. And so, yeah, this all happened very recently. This all happened like a couple weeks ago. So I just wanted to share it with you guys, first of all, because it's a question that we get a lot is, you know, when are you gonna have a baby and stuff like that. And so I wanted to let you guys know that it's hard to just go, when people ask me like, oh, when are you gonna have a baby and stuff like that, I don't want to like go into detail about all of this, but I do want people to know that, well, we are trying, and it's kind of been difficult for us. And so we are on this journey now. And also the second reason that I wanted to make this video is because I'm positive that there's other girls that go through the same thing, and so I wanted to let you know that you're not alone, that there are others of us that are having fertility issues and problems, and it is hard. It's so, so devastating because you think, like I said, having a family is so easy and natural and stuff like that, and then when it's not happening, it's really frustrating, and it's really, you know, have some rough days. Thankfully, I have, for one, a great husband to fall back on, as well as my relationship with God, because without knowing that, okay, this is God's will, obviously, and he has his right timing for me and for us to start a family. Without knowing that, I would be a crazy mess. But because we have that foundation, it's been easier for me to like kind of cope with and everything. So that's been good. But as of right now, we are going to start testing. I actually have a doctor's appointment next week on Wednesday. We'll probably vlog that day, and to try to do testing to figure out now what's my problem, because I've had two miscarriages in a row, as well as a chemical pregnancy, as well as this has been happening over the span of a year and a half. So we're going to be starting testing, and we wanted to take you guys along with us on this journey of what's happening in our lives right now. So yeah, that's pretty much all for this video. If you guys have any other questions, be sure to leave them down below and we will answer them in upcoming videos. Now that this is kind of a part of our lives, is trying to, you know, start a family, we wanted to share it with you guys and have you guys kind of go through this journey with us. And yeah, so anyway, I hope you guys liked this video, and if you want to see more of our journey to start a family, give this video a thumbs up. Be sure, if you're not already, to subscribe to our channel, and we will see you in our next video.